Hello, I'm going to be talking about the book Writers and Lovers by Lily King. So I read this book a little while ago, but I really enjoyed it, so I wanted to talk about it now and just sort of share my thoughts on the book. Writers and Lovers is about a woman named Casey Peabody, and at the beginning of the book, Casey is working as a waitress at a kind of upscale restaurant. She wants to become a writer, and she is working on her book throughout the book, so kind of a book within a book thing. And she is struggling with a couple of different things. She's grieving the loss of her mother and just sort of dipping in and out of depression throughout the book. So there is sort of a theme of mental illness. And then she's also in a bit of a love triangle. So she has two different love interests that are pulling her in different directions. So overall, I absolutely love this book. I think Lily King is so talented, and there are so many beautiful, beautiful passages in this book. It's a book that I'm sure a lot of people can relate to. So the character of Casey is kind of at a point where she knows what she wants. She wants to be a writer, and yet the other people in her life who once wanted to become artists are starting to realize that that dream is out of reach. And they're settling for other careers. So they're, you know, joining the corporate world and things like that. And so she's kind of starting to question, like, am I cut out for this? Can I even be a writer? Do I have what it takes? And she's just very caught in between these different paths for her life. And I think everybody can relate to that. Even if you don't want to be a writer or an artist, everybody wants to do something that they feel is going to make an impact in the world. And you kind of reach a point in life where you're thinking, like, am I capable of that? Am I a person who actually has something to say and who's going to make an impact? So that's kind of the place where she's in. And yeah, this book, I'm sure a lot of people will relate to it. I don't think that books need to be relatable in order to be good, but I think it's one of the strengths of this book is that it just feels very human and very real. And the issues that it deals with are things that I'm sure most readers will connect with. So overall, I just really, really enjoyed this book. It's very beautiful. It's very subtle. I think it made me cry. I can't remember now because it was a little while ago that I read it, but it will really affect you, and it doesn't, you know, try too hard. There's no crazy plot twists or anything like that. It's, like I said, a more subtle book, but absolutely beautiful. And the strong parts of this book are sort of in the subtle details. So I would definitely recommend Writers and Lovers. I know it's gotten a lot of good feedback online, a lot of people posting about it, so that's great to hear. I highly recommend it. I would give it an 8 out of 10. And so check it out.